Hey, what is up guys, Mr. The Reverts here, and last night Sledgehammer gave us a pretty big update in the form of a blog post, and there's a lot of good stuff in here that I want to discuss with you guys, so let's go ahead and get started. So first off, you're going to notice that I'm playing on the map Keratin, and the reason why is because on Friday, December the 8th, is going to kick off the first seasonal event for Call of Duty World War II, and it's called Winter Siege, and everyone is going to be able to play on a winter-themed version of the map you're seeing right now, Keratin, for free. So even if you didn't get the season pass or the deluxe edition, you can still play on this map again for free. So I assume this will kind of be like Winter Crash back in Modern Warfare, where the map is just decked out with a bunch of Christmas lights and trees. Just literally everything you can think of that has to do with Christmas is going to be on this map. Also, during the Winter Siege event, there will be weekly rewards for the players who are active during this time. So more than likely, you will receive a free gift in the form of a supply drop. And that's gonna have a weapon variant or a taunt or something along those lines every single week. And also guys, for the headquarters, they do kind of tease something involving the holidays as well. And Michael Kanji did the same thing over on Twitter yesterday. So I assume the headquarters is gonna have its own decked out version like Keratin. So that's gonna be really, really awesome. And also guys, starting today on the 22nd, there's gonna be double XP and it's gonna be active until Monday the 27th. So we do have a good 5 days to get on and grind some levels. And guys, remember to commend everyone inside the headquarters as much as you can, so that way their social score will be increased and everyone else can get some free stuff, and it's a win-win situation for everyone. Now guys, there are going to be some in-game updates that's going to be taking place next week, and there's a lot of good stuff in here. You guys might not like some of these changes, and then some of you guys may actually prefer these changes, but either way, let's go ahead and take a look at them. So first off, we just have some basic stuff including map exploit fixes, UI improvements, and fixes to issues with the party and connectivity optimizations. And then they also have adjusted the bar assault rifle to receive more recoil. So I'm not too sure how I feel about this, because I really enjoyed using the bar, and I think the weapon wasn't completely OP, but it definitely was one of the stronger weapons in the game. I just hope they didn't add too much recoil to make it hard to use, but either way, a good grip should relieve some of the recoil regardless. And then next up here, this is what has made a lot of players upset last night, and they've reduced the amount of flinch reduction that the basic training perk Prime gives you. But also in that same breath, they are testing a reduced flinch over all weapons in the game. So to kind of clarify here, the amount of flinch reduction that Prime gives you will be nerfed, but then the flinch as a whole is currently being tested. And to be honest, I personally don't notice too much of a difference when I don't use Prime. And a lot of players right now are debating if Prime is really OP or not. I do see both sides to the argument here, because the perk does offer you some pretty good stuff here. It's kind of like two perks in one, because it gives you an extra attachment along with the flinch reduction, but then again, I don't even notice a big difference while using Primed, and if anything, I just like it because it gives me the extra attachment in game. But tell me your thoughts in the comment section down below. How do you guys feel about Primed? And then lastly here, they have addressed snaking and a bug that occurs while using the smoke grenade. And I know you Game Battles players are really happy that snaking is going to be a thing of the past here. So guys, that was the update the devs gave us last night, and they also do go on to say here that during the Winter Siege event, there will be some new game modes for us to play, and I really can't wait to find out what they are. And I hope you guys are really excited for double XP today and the Winter Siege event, because I definitely am, and I just really love it when the devs are, you know, active with the community, because for one, it keeps us in touch with the devs and what they're working on behind closed doors, and two, it does reassure us that they are listening to the community and the issues, and they're looking to make this game better. So guys, that's it for the video. If you guys did enjoy, then leave a like, and thanks for watching. Till next time, I'll see you later. We'll